ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to BlackCatsNetwork.com. Tonight we come to you from DuQuoin, Illinois, as the Lady Black Cats take on the Lady Indians in a non-conference matchup. Good evening, everyone. I'm Brian Murley, and I am a solo tonight, and we are just finishing up the JV game. It's 40-38 in favor of the Lady Black Cats, and the Lady Black Cats are in the double bonus with and they have some fouls to give. So that's only their third team foul with 18.4 seconds to go here. Hadn't planned on showing you the JV game, but you know what? It's going on, so we're going to go with it. 40-38, 18.4 to go. And DuQuoin looking inbound the basketball. Three would win it, two would tie it. Lady Black Cats trying to play good defense here. Oh, that's a double dribble, no call. There's a timeout on the court. The varsity game will start here not too long after this. There'll be a warm-up time. I just had the time set to go on at 7:20 and thought we'd be done. And the time I realized that this game wasn't going to be over, it was too late to change the timing because I have up until 10 minutes prior to game time to change the start time, but it was about 5 minutes to go before I realized it wasn't going to happen. But the DuQuoin band down there is what you hear. It is loud in this gym. They don't have all the bleachers pulled out, so that doesn't help with the sound in here whatsoever. But the Lady Black Cats varsity comes in at 9-0. The Lady Indians at 2-5 tonight. And a black diamond versus a river-to-river matchup. This is one of the Lady Black Cats' final non-season tune-ups. They have one more tomorrow night against the Lady Bobcats of Meridian, and then it's pretty well into Black Diamond play. Next week they go to Vienna and Johnston City, both Black Diamond games. And that Monday night matchup will be a good one. Vienna comes in with an undefeated record as well, I believe. And Vienna's playing Massac County tonight in the Superman Allied Signal Tournament, something down there that they're playing in down there. But we're down to 6.4 seconds. Shot is up, no good. Down to 3-2. Shot's not going to get off. And that's the game. The JV team wins it 40-38 in exciting fashion. If you'd have told me they got to 40 points when I first got here, I would have told you you were crazy because they didn't. Neither team scored until 2 minutes to go, 2.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. So that's where we're at there. So we're going to take a break. I know it's still a little bit of time for game time. We're going to head hear a word from our sponsors. I'll let you know all about that. That way I don't feel rushed. Like I said, tonight I'm a one-man wrecking crew. I will be doing the graphics. I will be doing the scoreboard. I will be keeping a stat chart. And I will be running the video camera. So I'm going to apologize right now up front for any delay in any of that. I do apologize for that because it's just me tonight, folks. JR is at Cesar Valier tonight, where the junior high boys are taking on the Red Devils of Cesar Valier. Junior high girls got a win over the Cesar Valier Lady Red Devils last night in a game at home. They defeated them. That was a good ball game. Got to running clock. So Lady Black Cats, junior Black Cats are doing well as well. So I'm going to put some... I don't know why I'm doing that because I'm getting ready to run commercials. But we're glad you're here with us. Black Cats Network is a free service at Goreville School. If you'd like more information about Black Cats Network, you can contact us on our Facebook page or email us at blackcatsnetwork@gmail.com or contact@goorevilleschools.com. We want to take about 6.5 minute break here, hear a word from our sponsors, and we'll come back and we'll look at some Lady Black Cat stats for this season and talk about a little bit about tonight's ball game. You're watching the Lady Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com.
Southern Trust Bank is the only bank in Johnson County that is locally owned. Community banks touch every corner of our lives. They support us as we turn our life's goals into accomplishments. Goals like going to college, opening a small business, buying a home, planning a wedding, or having a baby. For your first car to life after retirement, our community bank is there for all your life's milestones. Southern Trust Bank is located in Goreville, Vienna, and Marion. Come out and visit the friendly faces at your local branch. FDIC Equal Housing Lender. Deb Gardner wishes to say thank you to Steve Webb, other sponsors, and JR and Brian for making the Black Cat Network possible. She's not the only one who shares the appreciation for the ability to watch Black Cat games and events through this streaming service from afar. She also wishes to thank the caring community of Goreville and its It Takes a Village approach to supporting each other. If you happen to have any real estate needs in the state of Florida, give Deb Gardner a call at 239-784-7947 or visit settlebythesea.com. Black Cat alum Noel Pease is proud to have his company, Pease Contracting LLC, support the Black Cat Network. Noel can handle any and all of your needs when it comes to lawn care, landscape, snow removal, or excavation. Reach out to Noel at 618-364-5140 for a free estimate. For grass, gravel, snow, or dirt, use Pease Contracting at a price that won't hurt. Don't get caught late in the game and find yourself running out of your favorite adult beverage. Stock up in advance by visiting The Oasis, conveniently located just north of Goreville on Route 37. The Oasis prides itself on providing a large variety and quality selection of adult beverages, including hard-to-find allocated spirits. If they don't carry what you're looking for, just ask. They'd be happy to try to get it for you. You'll experience quality, service, and convenience at The Oasis. The Oasis, a must-stop before your next adult gathering. The Goreville News is a supporter of the Black Cats Network and exclusively covers the Goreville Black Cats athletic program. If you have any news about Goreville, the Lake of Egypt, or surrounding area, let's tell the world and email them at contact@goreville.news.com. The Goreville News, your only Goreville newspaper. This year, more than ever, make sure you're well stocked with all your game time munchie needs. And you can do that by shopping locally and supporting small businesses, just like the Goreville Food Market. Conveniently located in the heart of Goreville, just down from the city park, the Goreville Food Market has everything you need to make streaming your Black Cat sporting event experience a great success. The Goreville Food Market offers a full grocery experience and boasts the best quality butcher department around that serves only fresh meat, never frozen. They're open 7 days a week for your convenience. Come visit the Goreville Food Market. Caitlin Parmalee, formerly Goreville Lady Black Cat and representative of MH Insurance Center, is your top choice for the local independent insurance agent. With top of the industry companies at her disposal, Caitlin has the tools to help you find better rates with better coverages. Whether it's home and auto, life or health, farm or commercial insurance, Caitlin and MH Insurance Center are here to help you protect what you can't predict. Give her a call today at 618-993-5262 and you'll be glad that you did. Dean Harper Auction is pleased once again to sponsor the Black Cat Network. Dean Harper Auction has been in business since 1967 and does both online auction as well as live auctions. They can help you sell your estate, household, real estate, as well as your farm. You can contact Dean Harper Auction at www.deanharperauction.com. Give Robin or Dean a call at 618-527-6500. For a no-cost consultation. Dean Harper Auction, serving Johnson County and the surrounding area, as well as supporting your Goreville Black Cats. Remember, everything sells with Harper. Natasha and Tony Stern's Country Financial Office is now open in Goreville at 212 South Broadway. They're excited to be a part of the community and look forward to supporting the Black Cats. Stop by and see them for a quote or a review of your current coverages so they can help you plan your financial future. They have offices both in Marion and Goreville. You can reach out to Natasha or Tony at Country Financial at 618-995-2241. Have you got a commercial or home project that requires more equipment and muscle than you have available? Well, you don't have to break your back to get the job done. You can save time and money with Suits Equipment Rental. Suits Equipment Rentals has all the tools and equipment you'll need to tackle any project, big or small. Call them today at 618-992-4433. Shanna Green from House to Home Realty says hello to everyone in Black Cat Nation. Team up with Shanna for a great real estate experience. Whether buying or selling, Shanna Green always strives for a slam dunk. Call her today at 618-771-2868 and let her assist you in your real estate game plan. Once again, Wiffle Boys Pizza is the official pizza of the Black Cats Network. The Southern Illinois original, located in the heart of downtown Goreville, offers pizza, subs, salads, soups, wings, and appetizers. You can place your order the old-timey way by phone at 618-995-9433 or order online. Download the Wiffle Boys app, available through Android and iOS, and look in the Apple Store or Google Play. They've also added a lunch menu and are open for lunch Wednesdays through Sunday at 11 o'clock. Call them now at 618-995-9433. Wiffle Boys Pizza, hometown, homegrown, and always homemade.
Always homemade. Don't forget to check out tomorrow's daily special, Friday. Two large one-topping pizzas and breadsticks for $30.99. Get that before you come to the games out tomorrow night. Tomorrow night, the Lady Black Cats will take on the Lady Bobcats of Meridian at 5 p.m. We'll be on the air for that at 4:45. And then there will be a JV boys game. And then following that, around 7:30, will be the boys varsity taking on the Bobcats of Meridian as well. So we'll have both the varsity games tomorrow. Also, don't forget to check out their lunch specials. They have a daily lunch special each day. They've got quite a few things on there. Chili or soup with half order of breadsticks. Side salad for $8.99. Small pizza and soda for $9.99. Specialty pizza and soda for $12.99. Wiffle sticks and soda for $8.99, or you get a free soda with any specialty salad. So make sure you check Wiffle Boys Pizza out. One of our, they've been a sponsor ever since we've started, and we appreciate them and all that they do. Lady Black Cats come in at 9-0. Lady Indians come in at 2-5. Lady Indians have fallen to Christopher, Caro, Woodlawn, Harrisburg, and Pinckneyville, some big schools there, and they defeated Murfreesboro and Benton. That's where they get their wins and the losses. Lady Black Cats come off a big win on Monday night as they defeated the Lady Wildcats of Marion by 29 points the other night. So good job by the Lady Black Cats. I'm trying to get back to the Max Preps page so I can share some information with you on scoring and the such. Abby Compton's leading the team in scoring at 21 points per game. She's also leading in field goal percentage at 56%. And Abby's averaging 10.4 rebounds per game. Brianna Suits is averaging right under 7 assists a game at 6.9. And Abby Compton at 3.8 steals per game and 1.8 blocks per game. So pretty impressive. Abby, Brianna Suits has made 17 three-pointers this year. Her and Kendall Webb are tearing up from back to there. Abby Compton has had, in the nine games, has had 5 double-doubles. And so I wish I could see the rest of the team stats, but a lot going on. Lady Black Cats are playing well this year, and shout out to them and Coach Gordon. He's got them playing very well. I'm trying to get Wi-Fi in here. Is not very good. Luckily, I got to the AD. They had a top secret. He had a top secret briefcase that had he had handcuffed to his wrist, and I had to hand him my iPad, and then he took it in a secret room, and I'm assuming he unlocked it and came back because he goes, here, you're on the internet now. And so very, very top secret, very hush-hush. But hopefully the signal's good. I am on their Wi-Fi, so but my phone, I'm just trying to use my cell, and it's not good. I mentioned Abby Compton, 21 points per game. Brianna Suits averaging 15 a game, and Kendall Webb at 13.2. So three Lady Black Cats averaging double digits. Pretty impressive. Assists per game, Brianna Suits with 6.9, Abby Compton with 3.7, and Ariana Elms with 2.2 per game. And steals, Compton at 3.8, like I said, Brianna Suits at 3.6, Kendall Webb at 1.6. And Kendall Webb is shooting 86% from the free throw line. So, and Kendall Webb also, this is a pretty awesome stat, 46% from three-point land as well, and Brianna Suits is 44% from three-point land. And Ellie Tripp at 33%. So pretty impressive. Abby Compton almost has 100 rebounds already this year. She's at 94 rebounds. And that's pretty good. And 16 blocks on the year. So pretty good start to your senior season, I would say. I'm going to take a short break, get a drink of water. We'll be back in 2 minutes with the starting lineup, Star Spangled Banner. You're watching the Lady Black Cats on blackcatsnetwork.com, a free service to Gorville School. If you'd like more information, contact us on our Facebook page or email us at blackcatsnetwork@gmail.com or contact at gorvilleschools.com. We'll be back shortly with the starting lineup, Star Spangled Banner on Black Cats Network. And we're back here at Black Cats Network as the teams get ready for the one-minute horn here. And then we'll have the starting lineups and the Star Spangled Banner here at DuQuoin High School in DuQuoin, Illinois. A lot of flags down there by the band, so we're going to try to capture that as best as we can. There's the fight song. Ironically, they use the Notre Dame fight song for their school fight song. And in their program, they actually have the lyrics to that. And I'm not going to read them, but they're right there. So you can sing along if you came to DuQuoin tonight. You can sing along with them. It's DuQuoin. All right. That's their thing. All right. And here's the public address announcer.
We are confident that our players, coaches, and officials are doing their very best
So Black Lady Black Cats going with their normal lineup. Brianna Suits, Ariana Elms, Kendall Webb, Jaylee Westerfield, and Abby Compton. Now for the... So the starting lineup for the Lady Indians to DuQuoin, Addie Denault, a junior, a senior number 11, Haley Sizemore, a senior number 12, Kaylee Ostriker, a junior number 13, Izzy Phillips, and a junior number 31, Abby Hill. So getting ready to go underway. Like I said, folks, I'm going to apologize right now because I am doing it all tonight since JR is away. I'm doing camera, I'm doing stats, and I'm doing the scoreboard. So I'm going to do my best to keep it all flowing and going. Abby Compton with the tip, tips it back to Kendall Webb, and we'll go the other way. Kendall Webb with the basketball over to Brianna Suits. Lady Indians come out in a man-to-man. Ball over to Westerfield. Kicks it out to Webb. Webb thought about the three, back to Suits. Suits gets it into Compton. Compton spins to the left, shot up and in. Abby Compton for two. Lady Black Cats picking up that three-quarter pressure. A near steal. Steal by Compton. Gets it out to Suits. Suits drives. Goes up left hand. Fouled. No call. Ball kicked out. Webb tracks it down. And ball back to Ariane Elms. Inside to Compton. Compton lays it up and in. Compton with 4 points. It's 4-0 Lady Black Cats with 7:13 to go. That's what the Lady Black Cats do so well, that pressure defense. They set back and then they wait for it. They get the ball up to Hill. Shot is up. Rims in and out. Rebound to Webb. We go the other way. Webb drives the whole way. She takes it up to the rim. No call. Lady Indians come down with the rebound, and they come the other way. Ball in the hands of Phillips. Phillips gets it over to Sizemore. Back to Phillips. Over here to Phillips. Phillips looking inside. They're trying to find Hill. Thought about the three, but decided against it. Shot is up by the Lady Indians. Up and in. 2 points for Haley Sizemore, making it 4-2. Favorite Lady Black Cats with 6:18 to go. Suits with the basketball. Gets it into Compton. Compton spins. Gets it over to Elms. Elms comes back right side. Webb drives baseline. She gets the baseline. Shots up. No good. Blocked. In the hands of the Lady Indians. We go the other way. Oh. Suits and Compton collided. We get the rebound. We're going to take a quick timeout, I believe. Yeah, Coach Gordon's going to take a timeout, check on Brianna Suits. Her and Abby collided, and that's like hitting a brick wall. So she says she's all right. She's holding her nose, though. No blood, so that's good. It'll be Lady Black Cats basketball. 4-2 here, 5:46 to go from DuQuoin, home of the Indians. So Suits brings the ball up, goes right side, gets it down to Compton. Compton spins back, gets it out to Webb, over to Elms. Elms thought about it. Back to Webb. Back over to Suits. Suits tries to get it into Westerfield. Can't. It's deflected, knocked away into the hands of Phillips, and she gives it up to Ostriker, and Ostriker brings the ball up. Ostriker picks up her dribble, gets it over to Phillips. Phillips being guarded by Suits. Gets the ball over to Denault. They kick it back over. Looks for Phillips down low. Can't get it. Denault fires the three. Her shot is up. No good. Rebound to Suits. We'll go the other way. Suits, oh, great off-look pass, and Compton tries to fire it back to Webb. Can't. That was a great off-look pass by Suits. We just couldn't finish. Turnover for the Lady Black Cats. 4:54 to go. Lady Black Cats lead it 4-2. Get the ball up to Hill. Back over to Phillips. Phillips drives left side. Gets it over to Ostriker. Ostriker comes back to the right. Bumped by Elms. That's going to be a foul on Arianna. That'll be her first, team's first. They'll take it out underneath. Kick it out to Hill. Back out to Phillips. Get it back out to Ostriker. Ostriker fires. Shots up and in. Three-pointer. Makes it five to four. Ball to Westerfield. Westerfield high off the glass. Up and in. Jaylee Westerfield makes it 6-5. Ball back to Ostriker. Back to Phillips. Looking for a cutting Sizemore. Back out to top the key. Shots up, no good. Rebound by Suits. They're going to say it was tipped out from behind her. And it'll say Lady Black Cats. It'll be Lady Black Cats basketball. Check in for the Lady Indians, number 23, Essence Haynes, who is a freshman. Try to get that clock in that picture over there. 3:41 and counting. Suits will fire the three. Left all alone. Her shot is up. No good. Rebound to the Lady Indians, and we'll come back the other way. Ball down in the corner to Phillips. Back out to Ostriker. Ostriker fakes. She drives. Goes left hand. Tries to pass it down low to Haynes. Haynes, the shot is up. No good. Rebound to Suits. Suits looking to run. Suits bounce pass up to Webb. It's knocked out of her hands. They're going to call a foul. They're going to get a foul on number 11, Haley Sizemore. That'll be her first, team's first. Webb is right there. Webb fires the three up and in. Kendall Webb for three. Makes it nine. I must have double tapped the scoreboard on the iPad because it jumped up to 12. Ball back over to Denault. Denault kicks it over to Phillips. Back to Denault. Near steal by Suits. Suits goes to the ground. Denault gets it. She tries. They're going to call a timeout. It's going to be a 30-second timeout. We'll take a quick break. You're watching Lady Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com. And we're back here at DuCoin. Lady Black Cats lead it 9-5 with 2:52 to go here in the first quarter. After that timeout by Coach Sean File. There's a steal by Compton. Compton lays it up and in. Abby Compton with six on the night. Makes it 11-5. They're going to get Compton for the foul. Reaching for no reason will be Abby's first, team second. Checking into the game, number 15, Mackenzie Eaton, who's a freshman as well. Young squad for Coach File. drives baseline. Ostreicher shot up, no good. Rebound to Compton. Compton kicks it out to Elms. Elms back to Compton. Compton will fire the long jumper. Shot's up, no good. Rebound to Phillips, and we'll come back the other way. Phillips gets it over to Eaton. Ostreicher kicks it over to Denault. Denault goes back to her left, being guarded by Compton. Down in the corner, three's fire. Shots up and in by Ostreicher. Makes it 8-11. Favor Lady Black Cats. Down to a minute 32. She can get out of it. Suits tries to bounce pass down in. 11-8. You got to keep an eye on Ostreicher. She can fire that three. Look to pull it up again. Mariana's got the duties of guarding Ostreicher tonight. Shots up, no good. Rebound to Haynes. See who they get here. They're going to get. They get Ariana Elms. That'll be her second, team second, or third, excuse me. And that will send Essence Haynes to the line. Jaden Tripp checking in for the Lady Black Cats, for the Lady Indians, number 11, Haley Sizemore. And number 25, Kinsey Ostreicher. Missed the layup, but got the rebound, put back up and in by Haley Sizemore. We just did not do a good job of boxing out there. 11-10. Suits with the basketball. She drives. Passes over to Tripp. Tripp is fouled. She'll go to the line. Shoot two. That foul's on number 15, Mackenzie Eaton. That's her first, team second. Jaden Tripp at the line. Shoot two. First one is no good. Checking in for the Lady Indians, number 31, Abby Hill. 11-10, 36.3 to go here in the first quarter. Jaden's second free throw is up, no good. Rebound to Sizemore. See if DuCoin holds for one shot. Ball around to Ostreicher, the young Ostreicher. Got Brianna Suits for a foul. That'll be her first, team's fourth. 16.1 to go. And that's going to be Brianna's third foul. And that will send Abby Hill to the line. Ellie Tripp getting ready to check in for Brianna Elms. So Abby Hill goes to the line, shoot two. First one is no good. In comes Ellie Tripp. Line, 11-10, 14.8 seconds to go. Abby Hill at the line looking to tie this ball game. Shot is up and good. Makes it 11 all. Ball down to Compton. Compton lays it up and in. That's where they got to keep going. They have nobody that can stop her. 3 seconds. Two. Shot is up. No good. And that's how we'll end the first quarter. Lady Black Cats lead at 13-11. You're watching the Lady Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com. And we're back here at DuQuoin High School. Lady Black Cats lead it by one, 13-11. Here's a look at your first quarter scoring. First for the Lady Indians, Abby Hill with 1 point, Haley Sizemore with 4, and Callie Ostreicher with 6. For the Lady Black Cats, Kendall Webb with 3, Jaylee Westerfield with 2, and Abby Compton with 8. DuQuoin band rocking it down there. JR's missing out because he'd probably been asked to sit in with his kazoo tonight. It'll be the Lady Indians basketball to start the second quarter. This ball down in the corner. Dribbles back to the left side. Gets it back out to Sizemore. Sizemore over to Phillips. Lady Indians being patient. Ball back over to Denault. Denault kicks it over to Phillips. Over to Ostreicher. Phillips fires, shots up and in, three-pointer. 14-13. Izzy Phillips. Suits drives. She's fouled. She'll go to the line. Fouls on number 31, Abby Hill. That's her second, team's first. Brianna Suits to go to the line for the Lady Black Cats. Her first shot is up and in. Abby Compton checking back in for the Lady Black Cats. Second shot is up and in. Makes it 15-14, 7-13 to go. Ball back on the other side. Back on top to Denault. Denault gets it over to Phillips. Phillips being guarded by Webb. Ball over to Ostreicher. Here comes that's got to be a moving screen. It is. That'll be Addie Denault's first foul, team's second. She'd have been fine as long as she hadn't leaned into her, but she decided to lean into her, and that's a foul every time. Well, supposed to be a foul every time. Sometimes not so much. Suits with the basketball, dribbles left. Gets it back to Compton. Compton drives, pops from 18. Up, no good. Rebound by Tripp. Tripp left hand up and in. Jaden Tripp. Makes it 17-14. Kicks the ball back over to the left side. Thought about the three. Now fires the three. The shot is up and in. Haley Sizemore for three. Makes it 17 all. 6 minutes to go. 6:05. Oh, good save by Compton. That pass, she was led just a little too much. Oh, tries to sneaky pass it in there and throws it away. 17 all, 5:50 to go. Haley Sizemore, that is now three threes for the Lady Indians. Ball over to Sizemore. Ball over to Ostreicher down the hill. The double team comes at the double dribble to be a turnover, and we'll go back the other way. 17 all, 5:36 to go. Here in this non-conference matchup between the Lady Black Cats and the Lady Indians of DuQuoin. Suits comes left side, hands it off to Webb. Webb finds what she spins back the other way, up and in. Abby Compton, that gives her double digits already. That is 10. Makes it 19-17, 5:07 to go. Hill is her size, but she is not her equal in athleticism. Ball down low to Denault. Good block by Compton. Compton needs to be careful not to foul there. Suits is on O-Striker like a wet blanket. That's going to be a foul on Webb. Trying to get through that pick. That'll be Kendall's first foul. Team's first this quarter. And they throw it away. Could not get it in. That should be ball back over here on the side because nobody touched it. And that's where they'll redirect it to. Try to get that clock in there so you can see the clock. 4:41 to go. Suits with the basketball. On the floor for the Lady Black Cats, you have Suits. You have Ellie Tripp. You have Jaden Tripp. Kendall Webb and Abby Compton. Get the ball. Compton out to Webb. Webb fires the three. Her shot is up. Too strong. Rebound to O-Striker. Kicks it up to Denault. Denault's shot is up and in. Tie ball game, 19 all. Addie Denault. Oh, missed her. Ball down to Webb. Or trip back to Webb. Back to Suits. Suits down to Compton. Compton layup up and in. Abby Compton now with 12 points on the night. Coach is saying we're really bad down here on defense. Jaden Tripp on Hill. Hill turns, fires up and in. That's 3 points now for Abby Hill. 21 all, 3:35 to go. Hands off to Webb. Webb hands off to Tripp. Tripp drives. Finds Suits. Now the double team comes down to Jaden Tripp. Tripp's shot is up, blocked. Oh, back to Webb. Webb gets to the rim. Too strong up to Compton. Compton lays it up and in. Abby Compton now with 14 on the night. I think there will be some defensive adjustments at halftime. Coach is not very happy with their defense. Haley Sizemore now with 9 points on the night. 23 all, 2:49. Ball over to Compton. Compton back to Suits. Back to Compton. Compton thought about it. Back out to Webb. Suits. Suits will fire. Shot's too strong. Into the hands of Hill. And we'll come back the other way with 2:23 remaining. Ball top to Key to Phillips. Phillips over to Denault. Kick it back over to Phillips. Here comes the double pick. Good recovery by Abby Compton there. Oh, there was an illegal screen. No call. O-Striker up for three. That gives her nine. And Lady Indians have a three-point lead with a minute 59 to go. Ball back to Compton. Back over to Webb. Into Suits. Suits drives. Contact, no call. Her shot is up, no good. Compton just hands it right over to Denault. Ball back out to Phillips. Back to Denault, over to Hill. Back to Izzy Phillips. Phillips too strong. They throw it away. And checking in for the Indians, number 25, Kenzie O-Striker. Number 23, Essence Haynes. And number 15, Mackenzie Eaton. 1:18 to go. Lady Black Cats trail by three here in the first half. Arianna Elms on the bench with three fouls. Ball over to Compton. Compton drives, passes down to Tripp. Tripp up off the glass, up and in. Jaden Tripp. Jaden Tripp now with 4 points on the night. O-Striker, they're going to say Suits fouled her. That'll be Suits' second foul. Team second. That'll send Callie O-Striker to the line. Ostreicher with 9 points on the night, the senior. Her shot is up and no good. 54.4 seconds to go here in the first half. Second shot is up. Too strong. Good rebound by Compton. She waited. Saw that it spun up, and she'll walk it up. We're down to 48 seconds. See the clock over there in your left-hand corner. Lady Blackcats trail by one. Ball over to Webb. Into Tripp. Tripp's shot is up. No good. Looks like she might have got fouled, but no call. Down to 30 seconds. Callie Ostreicher with the basketball on top. Hands it over to Mackenzie Eaton. Eaton being guarded by Webb. We're down to 19 seconds. Lady Blackcats will start playing defense about 3, 2, and 1. Ostreicher shot is up. It's short. Blocked. Down to 3. Oh, that's how we win. Lady Blackcats, first time I can say this all season, trail at halftime, 26-25. We'll be back in a few moments. You're watching Lady Blackcats on blackcatsnetwork.com, a free service of Gorville School. If you'd like more information about Blackcats Network, you can contact us on our Facebook page, which is probably the best way because JR is usually on there and he can usually get back to you. Or you can email us at blackcatsnetwork@gmail.com or contact@gorvilleschools.com. We'll be back. I'll be back here in about 3.5 minutes after a word from our sponsor. Sorry, there won't be any graphics because I'll be doing tally and everything else. But you're watching the Lady Blackcats on blackcatsnetwork.com.
For the only locally owned bank in Johnson County with locations in Gorville, Vienna, and Marion, visit Southern Trust Bank. Come out and visit the friendly faces at your local bank for all your banking needs. FDIC Equal Housing Lender. Deb Gardner is not only happy to support the Black Cats, but also available for any of your real estate needs in Florida. Visit her today at settlebythesea.com. Pease Contracting LLC wants to help with any of your landscaping, lawn care, excavation, or snow removal needs. Call Noel Pease at 618-364-5140 today. For grass, dirt, gravel, or snow, Pease Contracting always steals the show. Stop in at the Oasis just north of Gorville on Route 37 for any of your adult beverage needs. If they don't have what you're looking for, just ask Steve and he'll do his best to track it down for you. It's never really a party without the Oasis. The Gorville News exclusively covers all things Black Cats. Contact them at contact@gorvillenews.com with any newsworthy stories about the Gorville and surrounding area. Boasting the best butcher shop department around, as well as full grocery store experience, shop local at the Gorville Food Market, just west of the city park. They're open 7 days a week for your convenience. For any personal or commercial insurance needs, reach out to Caitlin Parmalee at MH Insurance Center at 618-993-5262. She can help you protect against the things you cannot predict. Going once, going twice, sold. That's the motto at Dean Harper Auction. Reach them at www.deanharperauction.com today for all your auction or estate liquidation needs. Remember, everything sells with Harper. Natasha and Tony Stearns at Country Financial want to help you with all of your personal or professional financial plans and protection needs. Call them at 618-995-2241 today to schedule your appointment. Don't break your back to get a job done. Save time and money with Suits Equipment Rentals. They have all the tools and equipment you need for any project, big or small. Suits Equipment Rentals at 618-992-4433. If you're buying or selling real estate, you want Shanna Green from House to Home on your team. Whether buying or selling, choosing Shanna Green is a slam dunk. Call her today at 618-771-2868. For dinner or lunch, stop at Whiffle Boys Pizza today, the official pizza of the Black Cat Network. Now open for lunch Wednesday through Sunday at 11 plus evenings. Whiffle Boys Pizza, hometown, homegrown, and always homemade.
Always homemade. Don't forget to check out their daily lunch specials. And they open up 11 a.m. for lunch. You check them out tomorrow for lunch and then get dinner. Two topping pizzas and something else for $30.99. I don't have the script in front of me for that. But Lady Black Cats Trail 2625. Oh, I'm listening. I was like, where does that come from? So here's the scoring for the first half. Lady Black Cats Trail. That's the first time I've said that all season. But here is the scoring for the first half. First for the DuCoin Lady Indians. Addie Denault with 2 points. Izzy Phillips with 3. Abby Hill with 3. And Haley Sizemore with 9. And Callie Ostreicher with now 9. It's either that's right or it's 12 and 6. But anyway, between those two, they've got 18. I'm not quite for sure. I'm trying to double check with Tara Pease. I can't remember who hit the 1-3. And then I gave it to one. I might have been the other one. For the Lady Black Cats, Brianna Suits with 2 points. Jaylee Westerfield with 2 points. Kendall Webb with 3 points. Jaden Tripp with 4 points. And Abby Compton leading all scorers with 14. Lady Black Cats are 2 of 4 from the line. And DuCoin is 1 of 6 from the line. Nope, I had it right. But on the scoring. So Lady Black Cats looks like they're a little flat coming out. Arianna Elms is in some foul trouble. Has gotten a foul trouble. She's got 3 fouls. She's been on Callie Ostreicher most of the night. They're senior, one of the two main seniors on this team, her and Haley Sizemore. And we're doing things nicely on offense, but we're just not, to me, we're not our defensive selves tonight. And I don't know what that is. I don't know if they saw the record of 2-5, but they also got to look at their competition. I mean, they lost to Christopher and Amaya. They lost to Pinckneyville. They lost to, you know, some really good basketball programs this year. And so I'm sure they most people would tell you that they are better than their record indicates. So hopefully Coach Gordon got some things straightened out, ironed out at halftime. And I'm going to take a quick break, but you're watching the Lady Black Cats. We'll be back in here in about 3 minutes, a little less than 3 minutes, the start of the second half. But you're watching Lady Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com. And we're back here at Black Cats Network. Lady Black Cats trail 26-25, and we're about 50 seconds away from the start of the second half. Just a reminder, programming note, tomorrow night we'll be on JR. We'll be back, be on the air around 4:45 as the Lady Black Cats take on the Lady Bobcats of Meridian. Then we'll take a break and have a second broadcast with the boys varsity, or JV will play, but then we'll take a break for that, and the varsity game will be on around 7:25, 7:30 tomorrow night as they also take on the Black Cats. So starting for the second half for the Lady Black Cats, you have the starters. You have Brianna Suits, Abby Compton, Ariana Elms, who has three fouls, Jaylee Westerfield, and Kendall Webb. Let's see what type of adjustments are made here at halftime for the Lady Black Cats. Suits trying to get it in. She gets it into Elms, gets it back to Suits, and we're underway. Down to Compton. Ball is tipped out of bounds. It'll stay right here. For the Lady Indians of DuQuoin, number 1, Addie Denault. Number 11, Haley Sizemore. Number 12, Callie Ostreicher. Number 13, Izzy Phillips. And number 31, Abby Hill. They get the ball into Elms. Right back down to Compton. Ball is tipped out. And we're underway here. Phillips with the basketball. It's like they're going to box in one here. Ostreicher being guarded by Elms. Elms has to be careful. She has three fouls. Ball back out to Ostreicher. Kicks down to Sizemore. Sizemore drives. Fires. Sizemore shots up. No good. Denault's there for the rebound. Kicks it out. Back out to Ostreicher. Ostreicher drives. Shoots the layup. Up. No good. Good box out by Jaylee Westerfield. And the Lady Black Cats will come back the other way. Suits brings it up the front court. She drives, kicks it out to Webb. Webb fires a three. Her shot is up and in. Kendall Webb needed that. That's 6 points now for Webb. She was pretty quiet the first half. Hitting that 1-3 is about all she took. Ball over to Sizemore. Gets back it over to Phillips. Ball over to Dalt. Down to Ostreicher. Gets it into Hill. Hill's met by Compton. Blocked from behind by Westerfield. Gets it to Compton. Coach is saying, let's go. No over in the back, but we'll take it. Suits drives. Oh, that's going to be a turnover. We'll go the other way. 6:36 to go. Lady Black Cats lead 28-26 here early in the second half. Get the ball into Phillips. Phillips will bring it up. 12-on-12. That's going to be an interesting matchup. Ariana just needs to stay out of foul trouble. Sizemore fires a three. Her shot's up and in. We might consider guarding her, too. She's got 12. And the Lady Indians take a one-point lead, 29-28. Ball down to Suits. Gets it over to Webb. They look down low. That ball was not quite high enough to Compton. And another turnover for the Lady Black Cats as we go the other way. Phillips with the basketball. Sizing it up. Kicks it over to Denault. Back over to Phillips. Phillips pulls up. Denault fires the three. Shot is up. Rims out. Hill's there. Hill with the putback, giving her 5 points. And now it's 31-28 in favor of the Lady Indians. Kendall Webb drives. Gets the line. She's fouled. Shot's up. No and in. No call. There's going to be a 30-second timeout by Coach Gordon. It's 31-30 with 5:31 to go. You're watching Lady Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com. And we're back here at DuQuoin. Lady Black Cats trail 31-30, 5:31 to go after that 30-second timeout by Coach Gordon. Long shot up and in. Gets the friendly row. Callie Ostreicher from downtown. 34-30. The ball over Elms. And yet another turnover by the Lady Black Cats. Lady Black Cats not having their typical game tonight. It is homecoming week. Maybe they're tired from that. Maybe they're overlooking them. I don't know. But they need to start playing. Ball in the corner to Denault. Denault fires the three. Her shot is short into the hands of Suits. Suits looking to push. That ball is stolen by Ostreicher. Up and in by Callie Ostreicher. That gives her now 14 on the night. 36-30, 4:38 to go. Suits drives, being guarded by Ostreicher. Kicks it over to Webb. Well, Webb will fire the three. Her shot is up, no good. Well, that was a travel, no call. And we'll go the other way. Denault with the basketball. Kicks it down to Ostreicher. Down wide open with Sizemore, blocked by Westerfield, but they throw it away. Ball into the hands of Compton. Compton drives, stops, fires, up. No good. Rims in and out. Thing did everything but go in. Ball up to Phillips. Phillips kicks it over to Denault. Down to Ostreicher. Ostreicher fires the long three. Her shot's up. No good. In the hands of Suits. Here we come. Suits gets it over to Compton. Compton drives. Her shot is up and in. Abby Compton with her first points of the second half cuts it to 36-32 with 3:26 to go here in the third quarter. Ball down in the corner. They get it down the hill. Good job by Suits. Can't hang on to it. It'll be the Indians basketball as number 15 checks in. Mackenzie Eaton and number 23, Essence Haynes. And down will set Haley Sizemore and Abby Hill. Marley Parrish still out with an ankle injury, probably another 4 weeks, hopefully sooner than that, but that was the time frame she told me the other night. Ostreicher three, up and in. That gives her 8 points this half. Makes it 39-32 with 3:09 to go. Suits drives, gets the lane, bounce pass over to Westerfield. Westerfield high off the glass, up and in. Jaylee Westerfield now with 4 points on the night, cutting it to 39-34. 2:49 to go. The floater, no good. Tracked down by Suits. Suits has it. Knocked out of her hands by Ostreicher. They're going to get Jaylee Westerfield for the foul. That'll be Jaylee's first. Team's first this half. The one dribble to nowhere. Back to Ostreicher. Back down to Denault. She fires. Her shot is up and in. Addie Denault now with 5 points, and the Lady Indians increase their lead to 8, the biggest lead of either team tonight, with 2:24 to go here in the third quarter. Suits drives, back out to Compton. Compton can't find the handle. She tracks it down, back to Suits. Suits being guarded by Ostreicher. Suits gets to the lane, shot up, no good. Rebound to Haynes, and we'll go the other way. Ostreicher gets it down low to Denault. Denault fires up and in. Addie Denault now with 7 points on the night, and the lead is 10. 1:50 to go. Webb drives baseline. She gets up and in. Kendall Webb. Kendall Webb now with 7 in the second half. 44-36. With 1:42, it's a full timeout on the court. We'll take a full timeout as well. You're watching the Lady Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com. And we're back here at DuQuoin. Lady Black Cats lead trail 44-36 with the minute 42 to go here in the fourth quarter. Pete Gordon calls another timeout. He's down to three timeouts. They didn't charge him for that injury timeout earlier. Lady Black Cats looks like they're going to pick up half court, maybe. Oh, Stryker with the basketball. Checking in the game was number the younger O Stryker, Kenzie O Stryker, number 25. O Stryker being guarded by Suits. Picks up her dribble, back over to Phillips. Phillips gets the stop. Oh, they're going to call Kendall Webb for the foul. She was straight up. Phillips jumped into her. Webb will pick up the foul. That'll be her second. Team second. That'll send Lizzie Phillips to the line. Or Izzy Phillips, excuse me, to the line. Shoot two. Her first shot is up and no good. So one thing Lady Black Cats have not done tonight, they have not got to the rim or to the rack or to the free throw line like they normally do. Normally, they're shooting a buttload of free throws a game, and tonight. They're going to get a foul on number 30. Number 15, Kenzie Eaton. It's her second, team's first. Nice pass down to Compton. Compton lays it up and in. Abby Compton now with 18 points, cuts to 45-38 with 1 minute remaining. Rebound to Webb. Webb kicks it up to Suits. Suits looking to push it. She gets the rim. Shot is up too strong. Compton's there to clean it up. She's fouled. She'll go to the line to shoot two. Fouls on number 15, Kenzie Ostriker. Oh, I'm sorry, Mackenzie Eaton. That's her third. First shot is up and in. 45-39, 39 seconds to go. Addie Denault checks back in for the Lady Indians. Compton's shot is up and in. Lead back down to 5. It was as much as 10. We're down to 38 seconds to go. Ball over to Sizemore, being guarded by Elms. Oh, that's a double dribble, folks. And Mr. Saunders got that one. 31.8 to go. 45-40. Compton gets it into Suits. Back to Compton. Down to 28. See if the Lady Black Cats hold for one as they go for it here. Kendall Webb gets the lane. She's shot. She is fouled. She'll shoot two. And that's a huge part of the Lady Black Cats game right there is driving to the rim, getting fouled, and going to the line. That foul's on number one, Addie Denault. That's her second, team's third. If you're wondering why you can hear the horn so loudly on when they blow the horn, because I am literally standing 20 feet from the scoreboard. 15. Suits is, or Webb second shot's up and in. Lead down to 3. Or 4, I'm sorry, I already hit that. 41-45. Ostriker with the basketball, down to 5 seconds. They get it into Hill. Ostriker fires the long three. Her shot's up. It's an air ball. And it's a three-point ball game as we end it here in the third quarter. You're watching the Lady Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com. And we're back. Lady Blackcats trail 45-42. Here's a look at your scoring. First for the Lady Indians, Addie Denault with 7 points. Haley Sizemore with 12. Callie Ostreicher with 17. Izzy Phillips with 4. And Abby Hill with 5. For the Lady Blackcats, Brianna Suits with 2. Jaden Tripp with 4. Jaylee Westerfield with 4. Kendall Webb with 12. And Abby Compton with 20. Ostreicher drives. Her shot is up. It's short into the hands of Webb. Webb tries to save it. They're going to say that it's our basketball, but okay. We'll take it. Lady Blackcats were 4 for 4 that quarter from the line. Makes them 6 of 10 now. And the Lady Indians were 1 of 2, which makes them 2 of 8 now from the free throw line. Shots up, no good. Rebound to Westerfield. Kicks it over to Elms. Elms fires a short jumper up and in. Sorry, didn't get it over there, but Ariana Elms, with her first bucket of the night, makes it a 1-point ball game with 7:18 to go. Let's see what the Lady Blackcats have this quarter. Ostreicher drives, spins. Her shot is up, no good. Rebound to Hill. Hill up and in. Hill now with 7, 47-44. If you'd have told me at this point in the game that Brianna Suits would only have 2 points, I would have told you were crazy. Compton being guarded by Hill. They like the and one. There's going to be a foul on Ostreicher. That'll be her first. Stricker. I've been saying Stricker. They say it. He said Ostreicher. So I apologize to all of Cali's fans out there. Shot by Compton, up and in. Gives her 21 on the night. 45-47. Jaden Tripp checks in for the Lady Blackcats. Compton shot is up, no good. Rebound to Denault. Denault gets it out to Phillips. Phillips comes up, dribbling left-handed. Gets it over to Sizemore. Back to Denault, back over to Phillips. Hill wanting the basketball. Ball up to Ostreicher. Ostreicher will fire the three. Her shot is up, too strong. Right back to her. Ball back out to Denault. DuCoin's coach. Oh, good hands there by Ariana. And Phillips had just let it go. It would remain their basketball, but she tried to dribble it, touched it, and it's a turnover. It'll be Lady Blackcats basketball. Suits with the basketball. Being guarded by Ostreicher. Comes to her right. Gets it out to Jaden Tripp. Tripp down to Elms. Oh, they missed her. Oh. Ostreicher steals, goes the other way, lays it up and in. 49-45. Ostreicher now with 9 points on the night. Suits drives, hands it off to Elms. Elms into Compton. Back out to Elms. Back over to Compton. Compton thought about the three. She drives. Contact. She's tripped. She's going to – it'll be Lady Blackcats basketball underneath the goal. That foul is on number 31, Abby Hill. That's her second. Team's second. Ball into Elms. Elms fires. Too strong. Jaden Tripp is there. Left hand up and in. Jaden Tripp with 6 points on the night. Cuts it 49-47, 5:17 to go. Ball up to Sizemore, back at Ostreicher, gets into Hill. Hill spins, tries to make her way through. She's fouled, basket's good. She'll go to the line, look, complete the old-timey three-point play. That foul's on Kendall Webb. That's her third. Team's first. Abby Hill. At the line, will complete the three-point play, up and in. 52-47. Suits drives, gets to the rim. She's fouled by Ostreicher. She'll go to the line to shoot two. That's Callie Ostreicher's second foul, team's third. Oh, Stryker's done a good job tonight on Elms. Elms, or Suits, I mean. She only has 2 points tonight. Both of those came from the free throw line. Now she is now 2 of 3 from the free throw line. Bree's shot is up and in. Gives her 3 points on the night. 52-48. 4:56 to go. Denal kicks it over to Sizemore. Sizemore over to Phillips. Back to Ostriker. Ostriker back to Phillips. Phillips goes right. Picks up her dribble. Down to 4:35. Ostriker drives. Throws up the layup. No good. Rebound by Elms. Elms kicks it up to Suits. Suits looking to push it. She gets to the rim. Left hand up and in. Brianna Suits. Coast to coast. 52-50. 4:18 to go. Black Cat crowd comes to life. There's a timeout on the court. It's going to be a timeout by the Lady Indians. Looks like it's going to be a full timeout. We'll take a break. You're watching the Lady Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com. And we're back here at Duke Coin. Lady Black Cats trail 52-50 with 4:14 to go here in the game. After that timeout by the Lady Indians and Coach Sean File. Ball into to Denault. Denault over to Ostriker. For Duke Coin to slow the ball down with this lead with 4 minutes to go. Lady Black Cats have been trying to push it, trying to get out and run a little bit. Just like that, Compton drives, lays it up and in. We have a tie ball game. Abby Compton now with 23 on the night. Tie ball game with 3:44 to go. Phillips kicks it over to Ostriker. Hill, no good. Rebound to Elms. Elms will bring it up. Elms over to Suits. Suits finds Compton. Compton spins, shoots up too strong. Rebound to Denault. Bree needs to get out of there and not pick up that foul. Ostriker with the basketball. Kicks it back out to Denault. Denault holds it, pings it back out to Phillips. Tie ball game, 3:05 to go. Ball over to Sizemore. Sizemore drives. Shoots the layup, no good. Rebound out to Suits. Suits looking to push. Hesitates, goes, gets to the rim, left hand up and in. Brianna Suits. And they throw Duke Coin, throws it away. Checking it for the Lady Indians is number 23, Essence Haynes. And there's another timeout on the court. It's going to be a 30-second timeout. I'll take a quick break. Watching the Lady Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com. We'll be right back. And we're back here at Duke Coin. Lady Black Cats have taken the lead 54-52 with 2:43 remaining. It'll be the Lady Black Cats ball to bring it the length of the court after that timeout by Coach Sean File. We'll see what Coach Gordon has drawn up here, what he wants his Lady Black Cats to do. Either team close to the bonus. Indians have 3 team fouls. Lady Black Cats have 1. Remember, you have to get to 5 team fouls before it'll be the bonus. Ball, oh, there was a push in the back by Denault. No call, but it'll stay Lady Black Cat basketball. Coach Gordon calling out the play that he wants. Gets it into Compton. Compton back over to Suits. Suits will fire the 3. Her shot's too strong. Elms is there. Left hand up and in. Arianna Elms. 4 points for Elms, and the lead goes to 4 with 2:16 to go. Oh, that was a travel. And it is another turnover for the Lady Indians. 56-52, 2:08 to go. Abby Compton inbound the basketball. Gets it into Suits. Suits being guarded by Izzy Phillips. Suits goes left side, hands it off to Webb. Webb goes right, finds Compton down low, and she's fouled by Denault. That'll be team foul number 4 and foul number 3 on Denault. Suits to inbounds. They run the stack play. Watch for Compton to pop up. Oh, they go a little bit different this time, and she's fouled by Denault. That'll be 4, and that'll send Abby Compton to the line. Minute 55 to go. Lady Black Cats lead 56-52. First shot is up and in by Abby Compton. Increases the lead to 5. Trying to make it a full 2-possession ball game here with this free throw. Her shot is up and in, and she does. 58-52. 1:54 to go. Stryker with the basketball. Kicks it over to Eaton. Over to Phillips. Back out to Denault. Denault thought about the 3. They get the ball into Haynes. Haynes spins, fires, shot up and in. The freshman, Essence Haynes, with her first bucket of the night, cuts it to 58-54. Suits gets it, hands it off. There's going to be a timeout. It's going to be a 30-second timeout by Coach Gordon. A minute 29 to go. We'll take a quick break. You're watching Lady Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com. And we're back after that 30-second timeout. Big Coach Gordon, want to talk over the thing. Lady Black Cats will be in the bonus for the remainder of the game. The Lady Black Cats have only 1 team foul this quarter, so they are far from. They could use a little strategy there. If they get to, you know, they looks like they're getting in close or something, might be able to foul and stop the clock. Don't necessarily have to. They get the ball into Compton. Compton is fouled. No call. She tipped up. Great job there by Arianna Elms. Gets it over to Suits. Suits is fouled, no call. They get it up. Stryker too strong. She couldn't believe she was that wide open. Suits looking to push. Coach like, no, pull it out. 1:05 to go. Oh, my goodness. He called that a player control foul after she's been getting the – you know what, knocked out of her all night. That is the 3rd foul on Suits. Minute 3 to go, 58-54. 1 minute, 55 seconds. Ooh, I'm not so sure Jaden touched that. They say she did. They were closer than I was. Stryker to inbound the basketball. Oh, nice push off there by Hayes. Ball back to Stryker. Get it into Hayes. Hayes spins, fires. up, no good. Rebound by Compton. Compton dribbles it out. Gets it across the half court. She'll take it all the way to the rim. Up and no good. Jaden Tripp up there, no good. No call foul on Abby Compton with 30.9 seconds to go. Only Compton's second foul. Team's third. Hill checks in for Haynes, and we have another timeout. 4-point game with 30.9. We'll take another break. You're watching the Lady Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com. And we're back here at Duke Coin. Lady Black Cats lead at 58-54 with 30.9 seconds to go. Lady Black Cats are in the double bonus. They have three team fouls. It'll be Lady Indians ball going the length of the floor. And so we'll see what Coach Gordon has instructed his team to do. Ball's in. Oh, that was a travel, and it's another turnover by the Lady Indians. Coach Fowl did not want that. Checking in for the Lady Indians, number 13, Izzy Phillips. And she'll come in for the freshman, Mackenzie Eaton. And another timeout on the court. We'll take another break. You're watching Lady Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com. And we're back. 27.8 seconds to go. Lady Black Cats basketball after the turnover by Mackenzie Eaton, where she traveled trying to find Callie Ostricker up the sideline. Lady Black Cats are in the double bonus. Imagine we'll try to get the ball in either Suits's or Elms's. There we go. We get it into Suits's hands. Gets it across half court. We're down to 22 seconds. Over to Compton. Compton over to Webb. Now they yelled a foul. And Coach Files just like, we just talked about this. You've got to foul them. Kendall Webb will go to the line to shoot two. Kendall Webb had a big third quarter with 9 points. Her shot's up and in. Her first free throw. Or her first point of the fourth quarter comes with 17.2 seconds to go and a 5-point lead for the Lady Black Cats. Webb's second shot is up and in, making it a full two-possession ball game with 16 seconds to go. Oh, Strikers. Oh, she wanted it. Did not. Oh, that's going to be a travel. Say she come down. 9.6. As long as the Lady Black Cats get it in and get fouled, I think this game is over. Lady Black Cats trailed as much as 10 points this ball game, but have fought their way back to take the 6-point lead. And there's a foul on number 13, Izzy Phillips. 6.9 seconds to go, 54-60. Brianna Suits could make this a three-possession ball game with these free throws. First free throw is up and in, 61-54. Our second shot, up and in. 62-54, down to 4-3. Ostriker fires. Her shot is up. No good. Rebound to Webb. And the Lady Black Cats take it, 62-54. Great win for the Lady Black Cats to come back from a deficit of 10 points and take this victory tonight. We're going to take a break here, a word from our sponsors, and I'll be back here to wrap it up from DuCoin. You're watching the Lady Black Cats on BlackCatsNetwork.com.
For the only locally owned bank in Johnson County with locations in Goreville, Vienna, and Marion, visit Southern Trust Bank. Come out and visit the friendly faces at your local bank for all your banking needs. FDIC Equal Housing Lender. Deb Gardner is not only happy to support the Black Cats, but also available for any of your real estate needs in Florida. Visit her today at settlebythesea.com. Pease Contracting LLC wants to help with any of your landscaping, lawn care, excavation, or snow removal needs. Call Noel Pease at 618-364-5140 today. For grass, dirt, gravel, or snow, Pease Contracting always steals the show. Stop in at the Oasis just north of Goreville on Route 37 for any of your adult beverage needs. If they don't have what you're looking for, just ask Steve and he'll do his best to track it down for you. It's never really a party without the Oasis. The Goreville News exclusively covers all things Black Cats. Contact them at contact@goreville.com with any newsworthy stories about the Goreville and surrounding area. Boasting the best butcher shop department around, as well as full grocery store experience, shop local at the Goreville Food Market, just west of the city park. They're open 7 days a week for your convenience. For any personal or commercial insurance needs, reach out to Caitlin Parmalee at MH Insurance Center at 618-993-5262. She can help you protect against the things you cannot predict. Going once, going twice, sold. That's the motto at Dean Harper Auction. Reach them at www.deanharperauction.com today for all your auction or estate liquidation needs. Remember, everything sells with Harper. Natasha and Tony Stearns at Country Financial want to help you with all of your personal or professional financial plans and protection needs. Call them at 618-995-2241 today to schedule your appointment. Don't break your back to get a job done. Save time and money with Suits Equipment Rentals. They have all the tools and equipment you need for any project, big or small. Suits Equipment Rentals at 618-992-4433. If you're buying or selling real estate, you want Shanna Green from House to Home on your team. Whether buying or selling, choosing Shanna Green is a slam dunk. Call her today at 618-771-2868. For dinner or lunch, stop at Whiffle Boys Pizza today, the official pizza of the Black Cat Network. Now open for lunch Wednesday through Sunday at 11 plus evenings. Whiffle Boys Pizza, hometown, homegrown, and always homemade.
Always homemade. Don't forget to check out their lunch specials. They're now open for lunch starting 11 a.m. Wednesday through Sunday. And don't forget to check out their daily special tomorrow, which is two large, two topping pizzas, I believe, and breadsticks for $30.99. Lady Black Cats come back and take it 62-54. They trailed as many as 10. They were down one that they trailed two of the four quarters, but they ended up, they did not trail on the quarter that matters the most, which is the fourth quarter. Lady Indians fall to 2-6. Lady Black Cats improved to 10-0. Here is a look at your final scoring. First, for the Lady Indians, Essence Haynes with 2 points. She was 0 for 2 from the free throw line. You're going to start to hear a pattern here in a moment. Izzy Phillips had 4 points, 1 of 2 from the free throw line. Addie DeNault, 7 points. Haley Sizemore, 12. Callie Ostricker with 17. She was 0 for 2 from the free throw line. And Abby Hill ends up with 12. She was 2 for 3 from the line. Lady Indian shot 3 of 9 from the free throw line for 33% for the Lady Black Cats. Jaylee Westerfield with 4. Ariana Elms with 4. Jaden Tripp with 6. Brianna Suits with 9. Kendall Webb with 14. Abby Compton with 25. Now, here's the difference. The Lady Black Cats, I said, you know, we normally get to the line in the first half. We only got there 4 times. Let me double-check my numbers. Yeah, 4 times the first half, and we were 2 for 4. Then we got to 4 for 4, which made us 6 of 8 for the game. And then in the fourth quarter, we got to the free throw line 10 times. So we finished at 14 of 18 from the free throw line, which is 7 and 9, which is 78%. So that was the difference in the ball game right there, 78% from the free throw line and getting to the line like we are capable of. Lady Black Cats improved to 10-0. It was a good test for them. They got down. Like I said, they were down 10, but they fought back, and they limited see, 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, held DuCoin to 9 points. We trailed by 3 going into the third quarter and held them to 9 points in the fourth quarter. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, outscored them 20-9 there in the fourth quarter. So great job by the Lady Black Cats. Lady Black Cats will be back in action tomorrow night. We'll be on the air at 4:45 as they take on the Lady Bobcats of Meridian in their final non-conference matchup tune-up before they jump into Black Diamond conference match games next week. Monday night they will be at Vienna, and Thursday night they will be in Johnston City. Both of those games on the road, and Vienna is a tough team. They're undefeated as well. We'll see after tonight. They're playing Massac as we speak, so I don't know how that game's going. But I thank you for joining us down here on Black Cats Network. Black Cats Network is a free service of Gorville School. If you'd like more information, contact us on our Facebook page or email us at blackcatsnetwork@gmail.com or contact@gorvilleschools.com. I'm Brian Murley. We'll see you tomorrow at 4:45 here on blackcatsnetwork.com. Good night, everyone.